Good morning, dear students. Welcome once again. This time in class 7 session, we are going to begin with chapter number 7, History, Tribes, Nomads, and Settled Communities. We will try to discuss about the tribes, who were the tribes, tribal people, who were the tribes. Then we are going to discuss about the nomads, who were called nomadic people, who were nomads, and who were the settled communities. Clear? Let's begin this chapter with the difficult terms. With the difficult terms, words, you can say, okay? Difficult words for this chapter. Number one is clan. Clan means group of families, clan. He is belonging to that clan. She is belonging to that clan. That means families, group of families. Claiming descent. Descent means the purvaj, okay? Descent, our forefathers, right? So claiming descent from common ancestor, ancestor, common ancestor, ancestor, our grandparent, great grandparent, ancestor. Like we are the ancestors of monkeys, right? So ancestor, that purane log, purvaj, right? So clan, the group of families who are claiming, who are acclaimed, who are claiming, who are declaring from a common ancestor. That means they are claiming, okay? They are taking it apart that they were from common ancestors, okay? To claim on something, to say that it is mine, okay? That is the meaning of claiming. So clan are the group of families claiming descent from a common ancestors, okay? Descent from common ancestor. Now nomads, another term is your nomads. Nomads are wandering people. Wandering means moving from one place to another. Wandering. Many times we may ask a question, why you are wandering? That means why you are roaming across? Why are you just wandering, going from one place to another? Okay? So, nomads are wandering people who are roaming, who are wandering. Both are same terms, roam and wander. Okay? Roam from one pasture to another. Pasture means field, land, cultivated farm. Okay? So, who roam from one pasture to another? Which? Herd or flock, that is animal group. So they are roaming from one pasture to another with the flock of animals, with the animal flock, with their herds, with their cattle, right? So the people who are roaming, who are wandering, who are going from one place to another, okay, who are moving from one pasture to another, one farming field to another, okay, they are called nomads. Another term is your itinerant groups. What do you mean by the term itinerant groups? The craftsperson, or you can say entertainers, one who does the entertainment, right? So entertainers or craftsperson who are traveling from one region, one place to another, practicing different occupation, right? You might have seen tamasha wala, right? Moving from one place to another, showing their tamasha, showing their different skills, right? So that is the meaning of itinerant groups. That means the entertainers, the craft person who travel from one area to another, traveling from one region to another, practicing different occupation, carrying out different work. Okay, that is the meaning of itinerant groups. Another question is shifting cultivation. This is a big cultivation, shifting cultivation. Okay, shift cultivation. Moving from one land to another. That is the main meaning of shifting cultivation. In this type of cultivation, first trees and bushes are being cut down. Okay, suppose if you move on to a plot of land, bushes are there, trees are there, and you need to do the farming or cultivation, then you need to clear the forest, cutting down of trees, bushes, then setting them on fire. That means you burn it. After cutting up of trees and bushes, you burn it. When it gets burned, ashes are left. Rock, ashes, right? Ashes are left. So ashes are mixed with the soil. Okay? When it is mixed with the soil, soil becomes fertile. Then crops are sown in that. Okay, crops are grown in that. Crops are sown. Crops, major trees, major plantations are being planted. Okay, so and when this land loses fertility, when these crops grow up, after some time, the land loses fertility. Why the land loses fertility? Just because these crops, these plants, take up the fertility of the soil. So once the land loses fertility, another plot of land is cleared. They move on to another field, they move on to another plot of land, and again they will do the same activity on another piece of land. That is called shifting cultivation. Very important question. You will get the question in class 8, 9 also. Shifting cultivation. What do you mean by the term shifting cultivation? That means trees and bushes are cut, then they are burned. After burning, the ashes we get, ashes are mixed with the soil. Then crops are grown, crops are sown. Okay, and when this land loses the fertility, another plot of land is cleared and planted in the same way. This is known as shifting cultivation. Very simple term it is, shifting cultivation. Okay, so these are the important terms of this chapter. Let's move on with the next part. Here comes the beginning of the history of this chapter. In large part, society, our society, was already divided according to the rules of Varna. Four words were there in our society earlier. Yes, Shudra, Vaishya, Kshatriyas and Brahmins. Right? Those four caste people were living. Shudra have the work of laborers or service providers. That means those people who used to work, they are known as Shudra. Okay? Shudra are the laborer group, or you can say service provider who can give work to other. So this part of the world, this part of the society is engaged with working and providing work. Okay, laborers and service providers, Shudra are the people. Another caste of people, another word was Vaishya. Who were Vaishyas? Vaishyas are agriculturists, those who are engaged in farming, and merchants, trader group. Agriculturists and merchants, farmers and merchants. Okay, Kshatriyas, rulers, fighters, warriors are called Kshatriyas. Rulers, warriors, administrators, they were Kshatriyas. And Brahmins, priests, scholars, teachers, knowledgeable people who used to impart knowledge among the students, they are Brahmins. Okay, under this fourth section, the society was divided. The society was divided into these four varnas, or in these four castes. Okay, now who are the tribal people? Because we need to learn about tribal, then nomad, then settled community. So who were the tribal people? Who are tribal people? Tribal people found in almost every region. That means they were found almost everywhere. But who were the tribal? Example, Khokar and Gakhars of Punjab. In Punjab, two parts of people you can find out. Khokar and Gakhars. Those people were of Punjab. Then Langas and Argans of Multan and Sindh, right? Nearby to Pakistan area, that people are Langas and Argans. They were known as Langas and Argans. Okay? They were of Multan and Sindh. In Himalayas or near about to the area of Himalaya, Himachal Pradesh and your Delhi region, there you have Gaddis of Himachal Pradesh, right? Gaddis people were there. Then in central and western India, peoples like Bhils were found. Okay. And in Chhattisgarh, you have Gonds, right? Gonds and Bhils of Chhattisgarh and MP, right? All these are examples of tribal people. That means our ancestor, okay? Our ancestor who used to live in forest, used to worship the nature, trees, stone, mountain, hill. Those peoples are tribal people. Our ancestor who used to live in forest, who were the people of ancient India, who were the people who were living from the very early times. Okay? Those people are tribal people. And these are the examples of some of the tribal people living in different area. Khokar, Gakhars, Langas, Argans, Gaddis, Bhils, Gonds. Okay, all these are tribal group, tribal people. Understood? So these are the tribal groups. People who were ancestors, who were living from the very beginning. And those peoples used to worship mountain, plain, river, valley, hill, plateau, rocks. They used to worship these things from the very beginning. Those peoples were tribal people. Example, lots and lots of examples are over here. Okay, so that are tribal people. Now let's try to find out the meaning of nomad. Who were nomadic people? Who moved from one place to another with their cattle, herds, right? Who used to move with their cattle, herds, animals, right? Those people are nomads. So nomadic pastoralists, pastoralists who used to work in fields also sometime, or pastoralists who used to take their animal for pasture, for eating, for providing them fodder, food, okay? So nomadic pastoralists moved over long distance with animals, right? Those people are nomads. It is given in your difficult terms also. They lived on milk basically because they have cattle. Cattle like cow, buffalo, goat, yak and something like that. So they lived on milk. Moreover, they exchanged wool, ghee, etc. with settled agriculturists. Moreover, if they don't want to drink milk, they can exchange milk with the food items and they take the food also sometimes, right? With the settled agriculturists. Agriculturists have crops and these people, nomadic people, have milk. So they used to exchange the material and take the each other's material so that they can have, settled agriculturists will have the milk and nomadic pastoralists will have the crops. So, barter system, the type of trade in which money is not exchanged, only items or different food crops or different items are exchanged, right? Barter system, you might know. So, these nomadic pastoralists used to give wool, ghee and other materials obtained from animal, give it to settled agriculturists and take the crops from them. Right? Yes. The best example is Banjaras. Most important trader group at that time. Nomads. These are nomadic people. They can't live at one place for a longer period of time. They they put their tent, remain over there, settle over there for some period of time. After some period of time, along with cattle, herds, they used to move from one place to another. They used to move to another place. So that is the story of nomads, nomadic people who move from one place to another with their animals. Okay, they basically have milk, wool, ghee, so they exchange wool, ghee, etc. with their settled agriculturists. Example of nomads, Banjaras. Okay, so this is the thing. These are called Banjaras. Now, bones. You have to understand the meaning of this word also, bones. Who were bones? Because bones belong to? Yes, Gondwana region, your region. Okay, Gondwana, MP and Chhattisgarh, right? They lived in region of called Gondwana. That's why this name bones come to this people. Those people who are living around the region, those people who are living in the area of Gondwana region, they are called bones. This Gondwana region is nothing but nearby to your areas of Chhattisgarh and MP. Gondwana region in earlier time, this area is known as Gondwana. Shifting cultivation is practiced by these people, Gonds. Gond people used to do shifting cultivation. What is shifting cultivation? Trees and bushes are cut, then they are burned. The ashes we get are then mixed with the soil, then crops are grown in that soil. And when the crops grow, they cut it, they utilize it, and again they move on to another field because the earlier field's fertility level got down. Okay, so they used to practice shifting cultivation. The large Gond tribe was divided into smaller clan, had its own king called Raja. So this Gond tribe was divided into another smaller clan. That means they also have different clan, different family. Inside Gond people, they have different clans, different families. Okay? And those different families are ruled by Raja, king. One Raja for one tribe. Okay? Yes. One example, Gadhakatanga was a rich state of Gond. That means if you visit that place, if you know this Gadhakatanga, okay, it was a rich state of Gond. Okay, Gonds are found over here in the region of Gadhakatanga. It was a small area nearby to Chhattisgarh and MP. Okay, Gadhakatanga. When Mughals defeated the Gonds, it was Mughals who have defeated these Gonds. They annexed, they captured, they won part of kingdom. So these Gonds tribe are almost vanished or almost extincted, almost ended just because Mughals have defeated them and they annexed their kingdom, they took their kingdom. Okay, because Mughals have defeated the Gonds and they took, they captured, they annexed their kingdom. That's why Gonds people are almost not found now. Very few Gonds we can find. Okay? Yes. So this was about Gonds. And one more thing we need to study about the Ahoms. Ahoms, they were the people who migrated, who came to Brahmaputra Valley from Myanmar. They shifted themselves to Brahmaputra Valley, nearby to the source of river Brahmaputra from Myanmar. Myanmar is the old name of Burma. Okay, so they moved from Myanmar to Brahmaputra region in 13th century. Okay, Brahmaputra flows in the state of Assam. So generally they moved from Myanmar, Burma to Assam, you can say. So Ahoms are the people who came to Brahmaputra region, who migrated to Brahmaputra region from Myanmar in 13th century, in 1299 to 1399, in between 1299 to 1399. During 16th century, they annexed kingdom, they captured kingdom, they won the kingdom of Chutias in 1523 and Poch Hajo in 1581. Okay, so in 1523 they won the kingdom of Chutias, and in 1581 they captured, they annexed Poch Hajo. By 1660s they made high quality gunpowder and cannons. That means these people are so brilliant, these people are so intelligent that they used to make high quality gunpowder and cannon. Cannon means top, right? Gunpowder, which is used in bullets, right? Bullets. So they used to make weapons, powerful weapons. Okay, they used to make gunpowder, cannons, and all those things. That means they were very sharp from their mind. That's why they were master in making up of weapons like gunpowder and your cannons. Okay, a home society was also divided into clans, into different family or khels. Their clan was also known as khels. What do you mean by the term khel? It is another term of clan, family, group of family. So a home society was again divided into different society, into clan, right? In the year 1662, they were defeated by Mughals. Again, the Mughals had also defeated them. Mughals also took their kingdom. Mughals also annexed them in the year 1662. That means Goans and Ahoms both were captured, both were defeated by the Mughals. Okay. Now, if I am going to talk about the differences between the Goans and Ahoms, which is a part of your question answer, you have to differentiate them. Okay, Ahoms have migrated to Brahmaputra region from Myanmar, whereas Goans are the Gondwana region people. Okay, they were the people of Gondwana region. They used to live in areas of Gondwana. Okay, they used to practice shifting cultivation, whereas Ahoms used to make high quality gunpowder and cannons. So these are the differences between Goans and Ahoms, right? Yes, so these are the differences. Now it's a time to note down your homework. Your homework will be define itinerant group and nomads. These two things you have to define. Itinerant group and nomads. You have to define these two terms. Okay? Yes. Note it down. You have to define itinerant group and nomads. And you have to write a short note on Goans and Ahoms. Okay? You have to write a short note on Goans and Ahoms. Mind you, you will get a question of making a differentiation between Goans and Ahoms as per according to your book. So be very careful. You have to know who are the Goans and who are the Ahoms. Who were these two kinds of people who were in the 13th century and what was their work? From where they have migrated, from where they came, and what was their main occupation, what was their main activity. All these things you need to know, because this is a part of the question. So this is very important question. Goans and Ahoms, moreover shifting cultivation is also very important. You have to understand what do you mean by the term shifting cultivation. What is shifting cultivation? How people used to do it? Okay, all these things you need to know. All these things you need to learn in this chapter. Okay, next time when I am going to come, going to come up with the question answer of this chapter. I'll tell you the question answer. I'll discuss the question answer of this chapter. Till then, it's a bye from my side. Have a wonderful day. Have a nice day. Stay home, stay safe, stay blessed. Okay? Have a nice day. Have a wonderful day, dear. Bye.